is the easiest concept of light that you will have. Totally easy. There are three things that light can do. It can reflect. I'll go ahead and write those down now. We'll pick up the other two tomorrow. You can have reflection. You can have refraction. And you can have diffraction. When light reflects, it bounces off a surface. And the easiest thing about it is the angle of incidence equals what? The angle of reflection. And I'll give you a video, I'll give you a demo in just 1 second, but I do want to show you this. Refraction is when light bends through a lens.
Like a prism?
Yes, exactly like a prism. It also bends through a concave mirror, but we'll get to that later. Refraction is when light bends around a barrier. Diffraction, bends around a barrier. We'll probably get to do this, if not tomorrow, we'll get to do it Monday. We can figure out how wide James's hair is, one follicle of hair, by using the principle of diffraction. We can get a laser light and shine it on the hair and put a screen back there, or a screen right here, and we can mark how much it diffracts, and we can do a little formula I'll teach you, and we can find out how wide the hair is. Pretty cool. I had a kid at Madison Central. She did a I put this out there a long time ago, and I'm not even going to ask you to do anything else at this point in the year. But if you happen to want to, there is a physics photo contest. And all you do is you take a picture, and you write a brief explanation about the physics involved, and you send it to AAPT, and you could win some serious money. It's a very cool contest. If you happen to be interested, I'll send you the link again. I think it may cost $25. It's not, but it's a great, those of you who like photography, awesome. But she did a red laser light, and she did a green laser light, and they diffracted. And what happened when the red and green light hit the screen?
Got yellow?
They got yellow. Totally friggin' cool. Okay, so enough digression. Let's go to this angle of incidence. So if you have a flat surface like this, and in comes the light, this is the angle of incidence, and we always draw a normal line at the point of incidence. This is our reference from here on. This normal line, and you remember in physics, normal means?
Perpendicular.
Perpendicular, very good. So the angle of incidence is actually this one right here, between the normal and the ray. So in comes the angle of incidence, and let's say this were, what does that look, about 50 degrees, right? Then guess what? The angle of reflection is also 50 degrees.
But in the opposite direction.
The opposite direction.
It's like if you shine a laser directly into the light, and like you can shine it like directly into itself, you're not going to see it like anywhere
else. It'll come right back.
Yeah.
It comes right down the normal.
You can shine it like somewhere. It'll be like over there.
We'll have a little target practice in here with mirror and a laser, and you'll try to hit a target. You'll have to get the angle of incidence to equal angle of reflection, so it'll hit the target. Okay. Now, there's a really cool phenomenon that happens with fiber optic cable, like we use for telecommunication. And here's what happens. Totally Cool. Let's get the red. If you shine the laser into the fiber optic cable at the critical angle, guess what happens? It's total internal reflection. And so what happens is that laser never leaves the cable until it gets to the end. Is that not cool?
That's pretty cool.
That's called total internal reflection, and that's what makes fiber optics happen.
Okay.
Now just a brief addition to that, the way that is communicated is binary code. Now, I'm not going to ask you to learn binary code, but it's something like this. Off is a zero, on is a one. So the laser goes on, like that. Like that right there is something. I don't know. It's a number or a letter. And that's how the code is sent. On, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, etc. That sends out the letters of the communication, or change it to video, or change it to audio. And that's how it's communicated, by binary code. Thank you very much.